What's up, everybody? Welcome to the Loud Spot. I'm your host, Sebastian. I'm hanging out with my co-host, Southern Flame, Don McIntyre over there. And underneath us, we got Joey Arena for the second time coming on the podcast with his band, Ovtlier. What's up, dude?
What's up, everybody? How are we?
I'm good. I just realized I did something. When I say what's up, everybody, I clap my hands. I didn't realize that before, but it felt so comfortable. I must do it all the damn time.
You do.
So, Ovtlier, you have came out with a new song, a new music video, and you guys were on Octane Test Drive, right?
Correct. Yes.
Nice. Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, we dropped Blame the Dead fairly recently. That was the one, and ended up going to Octane. That was very quick. That came together in a matter of an hour. We didn't realize, you know, we didn't know that ahead of the premiere of that. So, then we, a couple weeks later, which was most recent, we ended up dropping Nemesis. We're just like, you know what, let's just strike while the iron's hot here and start releasing all this material we've been sitting on for a while.
Dude, nice. Nemesis is such a cool song, man. You know what, though? I'm not surprised, because when you were on 10, 11 months ago, we played your song Bulletproof, right? And I remember showing that to several people. I was like, check out this cool fucking song. Like, it's super sick. And this song, Nemesis, it has just as much energy as Bulletproof does. All your songs, even when it was on the Octane Test Drive, it had a bunch of energy. And it was so cool, because I was listening to Octane. I was like, these guys were on my podcast.
Hell yeah. We, dude, the energy is just, I don't know, man. I think everybody's feeling some type of way after the past couple of years, you know? So, all the music we've been sitting on and writing, it's the release for me. And also, it's all that aggression that built up the, you know, the hypocrisy of human and society and politics. It's like, it's just done. It's like, I'm done with it all. It's all coming out now, and that's it. I'm done with the whole, like, I don't know. Let's write about COVID. Let's write about sickness. Like, I'm just like, no, dude. Like, that's a thing. Have your outlet, absolutely. But every band hops on these bandwagons, and it's like, for me, it's like, dude, let's talk about the bigger beast, you know? And that's what I want to talk about. The thing that's, like, creating division and just mind fucking humans into like a place of just hating one another. I just cannot get into it anymore. Everybody talks about peace and love and accepting of one another, but those are the same people that are quick to judge and just, dude, I don't think 30 minutes is enough. I don't think 30 minutes is enough from what I have to say.
It's like my wife and I always talk about, you know, we see people come out of church and we're like, oh, they're judging us already. Like, you go to church to not judge, right? But then they're the ones that judge the most, it seems like, anyways, for the most part. And same thing, people are always saying, you know, peace and love. They're the ones that are judging everyone else. Dude, it's the world's fucked, man. That's just the way it is, dude.
The opposites, the polar opposites are literally the same people. It's so funny. They just have two different religions, and one of them is, you know, the idea of a faith, and unfortunately it becomes so bad that I think it actually gives the idea of that faith a bad name. And then you get the other side of it, where it's just, again, peace, equality, the whole, like, this modern hippie idea, but you're walking contradictions as well. They both can't stand each other, but they're both the same people. And so, but that's usually what it is, though. Like, my dad and my brother, who are the most alike, you know, they butt heads the most. It's kind of what it is.
If I met someone just like me, like, I probably would not like them.
Same.
Like, piece of shit.
Right, exactly.
Yeah, honestly, to go back to the same thing, you know, I realized something not even that long ago. We'll get back to music, but this is a fun topic to talk about. There's, you know, there's your extreme political parties, right? You have the left and the right. And I was watching this show about the extremist, and people that are even in the middle, but they kind of go one way or the other, tend to, when they see someone else who's also in the middle, but the other, they'll tend to kind of go more extreme with their arguments. And really, that's almost not a need. Like, I'm friends with so many people now that have different views than me. Because once you understand why they have those views or where they come from, you can kind of understand why they think that way. And then you kind of don't, you hate them less, I guess, or you find a common ground to agree with them on.
Dude, 100%. I completely agree with that, especially myself. I don't belong to any political party. I don't judge if you do. I should say I don't care if you do. I'll say that. And I don't judge really, but there's a lot of hypocrisy on both sides. So I'm like, so like, I try not to judge, but I definitely want to like, I have an urge to call people out on their bullshit, but I don't, because at the end of the day, man, I'm sure like, you know, I have my quirks that people can call me out on and stuff like that. I try to stay as, you know, humble in my own bullshit as much as possible. So, but again, like what you're saying though, it's like understanding people is the biggest thing in the world, man. And I think it's even deeper than politics though, because it goes into, I believe, psychology and your like of your upbringing. I think it's so deep rooted even more so, because it starts with the home. It starts with the parenting. And that's what like my old songs, like I'm starting to finally use music. Like I never wanted to talk about my stuff and my upbringing. I was like, oh, it's completely normal. And then it finally took me going to a therapist a couple of years ago because of grief. Then she goes, wow, I'm a drug counselor and you had a fucked up life. And I go, nah, it's okay. And she goes, no, it's not okay. Stop saying that, because all you're doing is just burying this shit and it's going to explode one day. And that's the thing is like, we have, so a couple of years ago, I wouldn't have been able to talk to you like this, but because of some, you know, mentoring and guidance on a professional level, I'm able to do that now. And, I realize more and more people, they side with politics because everybody wants to, I mean, it's human nature to be tribal and we all want to feel like we, you know, we are accepted and belong to something, but then it becomes like sports teams and it's not even about like policies. It's not about policies anymore. It's literally sports teams. It's like, we need to get, like, I've seen both sides say, we need to get this person in office, and it's not because of a policy. It's not because of something else. It's literally because it's my team versus your team.
Dude,
popularity contest.
It's, well, people fight over, I mean, you watch college football, and I'm not saying you watch college football, but I watch college football sometimes, and literally people will fight and have fist fights over their team. They don't even freaking play for the team, dude. Yeah. Politics is almost like that. It's your team versus my team. Whether you agree or disagree, it is, you know, that's the way people are. It's kind of sad, but you know, Joey, you and in your lyrics and your music, and the first time I talked to you, you're an outside of the box thinker, which is so perfect. I think most musicians are, you know, outside, not everyone, but most musicians are outside the box thinkers. You don't want to go with the norm or go with the herd. You want to have your own thoughts and just provide, you know, I do my own research and my own information research. I don't listen to anyone. I think everyone needs to do that.
Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. The biggest thing is the lack of education, the lack of like follow through of understanding things. Like, honestly, I think people should be a skeptic to at least some degree, question everything. I mean, dude, atheists do it all the time, and there's nothing wrong with it. Like, they don't want to believe in anything, but yet they're quick to believe in their government. So it's like,
right. Yeah.
So you don't want to believe in faith or energy or like whatever, something that you cannot see, but you put your faith in flawed, corrupt, perverted man. What? Like, I can't. And it's like, again, I don't even care about what you believe or don't believe, but it's at the end of the day, the hypocrisy. We can always, there's so much hypocrisy, and we just need to kind of like, I think, laugh at ourselves and go, yeah, I was kind of full of shit when I thought that for a moment in my life. And like, just humble the fuck out, man. Humble out. Like, the humility is great. It helps you build character. And like you said, I mean, honestly, Ovtlier, it's in the name. That's why I felt like for the first time in my little musical endeavor that Ovtlier was the best representation of me as a person. It's not just like a cool name. It is something that's like one word to describe yourself. That is it. I am literally just a body separated from trends and fads and political ideas, right, and religious ideas. And like, I do me. I have my own beliefs. I have my own ideas. I have my own things and thoughts on it all, but I don't want to ever push that on somebody. I want you to like think for yourself and live for yourself and accept yourself and love yourself. I think if the world were to honestly just love itself like truly love itself and accept itself and whoever they are and what they want to be, they will worry less about others.
Yeah.
That's why you worry about others.
Even if you tried to call someone out because you disagreed with them, all you're going to do is make them believe more in what you don't believe in. That's all you do is you push someone, you know, don't do that, you're going to do it.
There was a Harvard study that I heard. I'm not sure when I heard it recently. I can't recall when it was, but it said that a person who is wrong, especially in relation to politics, more say. So like nobody's gonna really go, yeah, I fucked up voting for this person. They're just gonna be like they're gonna want to back it even harder, even though they know that they're wrong, But nobody wants to own up to things. So, like, and that's, again, it's not just in this current political affair. It's the one before and one before and one before.
Yeah, I mean, I've done that myself, man. I literally have, oh, crap. And then I defend it because I don't want to be wrong. You know, but, you know, the older I get and the more I talk to people through podcasting and different points of views, it's really opened up my knowledge of the way people are and the world. So,
yeah.
All right, Nemesis. This song, I love how you call it you don't call it a lyric video. I wrote it down. It's an official visualizer. but it's kind of like a music video. Is that real people that you know that are in it, or is it just like you just paid someone to throw some stuff together? Because you have the lyrics on there also, which is super cool that you do, because I know what you're saying.
Right. Yes. So the reason why we went with a visualizer on this, and you know me, I like to just keep it transparent and 100. So we were having music video issues with Blame the Dead. And the song lyrically is very, very touchy. The song is about unity. So the video has to literally just back that. And unfortunately, we had missed, the director, I'm not going to name his name, but the director had missed multiple deadlines. And, there was a lot of back and forth. And then we had a premiere with New Fury Media, and shout out to them. They've been truly great people and super understanding the process of this. And I got the video for the third final release date after we hyped it. And I did a copy of the video within 15 minutes before the actual premiere. So it's probably whatever. And I end up uploading it without even checking it out. And now I upload it. We send him the link. And I go, you know what? This song needs to be portrayed in the right way. Let me check this out. I looked at it and it's like, dude, it is just polarizing on just all sides, without any resolution, without any sort of like unity, which is literally what it's like, dude, wide of the fucking mark, bro. And I just could not, I'm like, this is not, I cannot release this because I'm not about that. Again, I'm not left, I'm not right. I don't care what you are. I don't care what you do or identify. I don't care. I don't care. Do you love you? That's it, man.
That's right.
So in the video was, the song, it was an obvious, like the video was my, I just wanted it to be an obvious approach toward just being inspired by the Matrix, honestly, like a simulation, honestly, because that's what I feel like what we're in, and honestly, this whole thing is just like the task of the simulation now at this point. And so I wanted it to be a dead ripoff of like Matrix, and it ended up becoming just a, it's like either, you know, it's like Fox News and CNN, like every other thing. And I'm like, but there was no resolution. There was no, again, and the song's about resolution, not just, more division.
In the song.
Well, let's play this song. The song's called Nemesis. I fucking dig it, dude. I dig it. But before I play the song, I do want to say one thing real quick. I would like to say, do you boo boo? And here we go.
Nemesis. me like gas on a fire. Your word means nothing. Death is my muse, but most are afraid. I walk through the darkness as you run away. You're a fire, you get what you deserve. If you cross me, you're gonna get burnt. I see the world in photo negative. Where poison is my medicine. I made peace with all of my skeletons. For you, I'm the nemesis. I am the enemy. For you, I'm the nemesis. I am the enemy. For you, I'm the nemesis. The way you see me is who you made me. I am the enemy.
Let me unmute everyone. I muted everyone here. Let me unmute. I love.
Holy hell.
I know.
Shut up. That was okay. Some major fucking Octane vibes right there. No doubt. You brought some motionless and white energy to that shit. You've got your own sound. But when I tell you I'm surprised, okay, I hear Bulletproof, right? And you've got your own thing, your own sound. And then Sebastian just lays that out on me. And I'm like, oh, hell. Great job.
Thank you.
Awesome.
I appreciate that.
Hell yeah. Definitely Octane worthy.
Dude, 100%. I mean, if they don't start rocking that song, man, then I'm going to start protesting.
Jose. Dude,
so I know, right? So, like, honestly, we don't, it's like they, you know, they've given us a lot of love. So I'm completely grateful for everything that they do spin, whether it's, you know, we only get a week or we get, you know, a full ad. It's just like, you know, there's a lot of, you know, great artists out there, and it's just like a time thing, you know, it's really like luck and timing, I guess, because, you know, the song could be great. You know, there's a lot of artists that put out great songs and they just, you know, I don't want to say they don't make the cut, but I think that they only can just add so much or squeeze so much. And it's like, you know, when it's your number, it's your number type of thing. So yeah, we got a lot of fans that are just commenting on their pages. I mean, the last test drive, we couldn't even believe it, but like their Facebook, their Instagram, everything got bombarded with Ovtlier. It was like 90% Ovtlier, and it was great. Like the fans are incredible, man. And that's just what we need. Again, it's power to the people, man. And that's it. We need their voice. It's old school, man. It's the voice of the people. So
nice.
It's so cool. And you're right. You know, being on Octane, I mean, there's tons of great artists out there. There just are, especially, you know, you get a lot of 30 and early 40 year olds that are seasoned musicians. Okay. That have just this talent. Just, I mean, there's most of the bands on my podcast are like really, really Octane worthy, you know? And, yeah. And sometimes they get played on test drive, they play them for a little bit, then they kind of go away. But that song, dude, the energy that you bring and the vibe, I love where you say, when Don told me to shut up. Well, you know, she had to, because I don't shut up. She doesn't tell me to shut up.
Don't ever shut up.
Yeah, I don't.
I love you, though. I love you both.
You said, make. I made peace with all of my skeletons, dude. And I thought that was a really neat line, but then you also say, fuck you, I'm the enemy, or whatever. So it's almost, almost like maybe contradicts each other a little, but it's like you've made peace. So is it like you've made peace? So do you, boo boo? Is that
when you finish? Yeah, so the song is really about healthy boundaries. And I believe that healthy boundaries are not always in a, I don't want to say a, they're not so cut and dry as shaking hands and going your separate ways. You know, it's always, you know, how many times have you know, you have somebody in your life that whether it's a significant other, a close friend or somebody, and it's like you're shaking your hand, you know, but in the other, they have a knife behind their back. You know what I'm saying? Like people have. Unfortunately, there's just evil people out there, and sometimes they, you know, they wear a mask, and you know, we try to see beyond it, we try to accept them for something, and then all of a sudden it could just like turn on you. And this in particular was a person that you know, I had in the band a long time ago, and just had to say, man, it's just he's just not a very good person, to say the least. And we just, I like, just get the fuck out of my life. That's it. Like now it's at a point where it's like, you know, you did me dirty. You try to run your mouth about me, say I'm like the devil and all this shit. But then all of a sudden you're calling me to be, you know, back in my band and begging me like, yeah, I'm so evil, but yeah, you want to be back. Right. And then, you know, like he's harassing our photographer, our female photographer on tour, and it gets uncomfortable. And I had to step in. And you know, he's harassing a female, and like it was out of line. It was, you know, and the whole band spoke up in agreement. But for me, for some reason, I was the one, even though we all said the same thing, but I was the, you know, I'm the scapegoat. So that's what it was. And what's that?
You took the fall. You took the blame.
It's usually what it is, man. When you're the spokesperson of the band, you get the love and you get the hate. So whatever it is. So
come on, Joey. Just
you that's go. Okay. You did the right thing.
Right. So the song is now, it's like, dude, you know what? I tried to do like the thing where I just swallowed it, let it go, pass me, you know, bygones, and all that bullshit. But it's like, you know, dude, you look up the definition of narcissist in Webster's and you'll find his face. So it's kind of like, you know what, dude, you hand me the scissors in which, you know, I cut ties and you struck a match that burned a bridge. So now it's like, fuck you. It's made cut and clear. I'm your enemy. And I pray, you know, I look forward to the day that we cross paths. I'll just say that.
Snippity snip, motherfucker, kick rocks.
That's it, man. That's what it is. It's like, get the fuck out, dude. Like you're toxic. Get out of here.
How much has the band changed since? And you know, I'm gonna let Don ask the next question after this one, okay? Because I've been talking a whole lot. But how much has the band changed? Has the band changed at all in the last 10 months? I mean, COVID's kind of subsided. You guys doing shows again? Any significant changes in the last 10, 11 months since I've talked to you last time?
Kind of. I mean, so we have restructured our team on the business end. It's a lot of stuff that's not really exciting to talk about. I mean, there are necessary changes on the back end of things, the stuff behind the curtain. You know, we kind of got back to the core four. The band started off as a four-piece. Now we're back to a four-piece. And that's where it needs to be. We had somebody filling in, you know, said person. He was filling in for a tour, and unfortunately, like, you know, it's one too many. So back to that, restructured the team, just strengthened the relationships that we already have with people, and just built new ones, honestly. And that's kind of it. Just a lot of studio time, lots of one-off shows and festivals here and there. We're currently between agencies as far as booking goes. That's why we're not just like full-fledged out on the road, but at the same time we have a lot of music that we're getting ready to release now. I mean, I feel like we were just dropping like a single, you know, every, I don't know, I felt like once a year, maybe two times a year, but now it's like just that's it, throwing it up at everybody.
Awesome.
Right. So what shows do you have coming up, or can you talk about
that? We play a mini fest at the month in Rhode Island, in Providence, which will be, that's going to be fun. It'll be fun to play. It's going to be exhausting because we have the 30th, we are shooting a video for a new song, and then we have to drive 6-7 hours, like immediately after. So after like kind of doing video all day, we got to go play a festival the next day, and then drive back. And then we will have August is like 2-3 weeks of studio time. And then October, we're playing in Vegas for a mini fast call when we were hungry. It's a...
Oh, I'm going to be there.
Yeah.
Wait, when we were young or when we were hungry?
When we were hungry. I'm podcasting that event.
Uh-huh. Oh, dude. Oh, yeah. I'm there.
Modern Day Escape, William Wenzler, bass player, reached out to me on Facebook when it was just a thought. He was like, hey, would you... Yeah. Actually, I just had him on the show not that long ago talking about the when we were hungry. Pancakes in the pit, bro.
William's a good dude. The Modern Day guys are they're really good people. I'm excited about this because, you know, coming from more of like the Warped Tour background and like my old bands and stuff, you know, doing, you know, Warped Tour and shit, like these are a lot of bands and people like from that era. So it's kind of cool that, you know, we get to all like you know, meet up and hang out again and stuff. So it's gonna be a little bit of a nostalgia fest. So
yeah, it's cool. I'm excited to talk to what's the band's name? The Dropout Kings are going to be there. Of course, Modern Day Escape. There's a bunch of bands. I didn't know you were going to be playing that, so I'm excited. I'll be there podcasting, do a little mini interviews with all the bands that are there behind the stages. So I will also see you, and then we'll get you on for a third time.
There we go, dude. We got to do a face-to-face or a physical one. That'd be the best.
Oh, dude, I cannot wait for October. It can't come fast enough, but at the same time, I don't want October to be here because that means I got to get up early and take my kids to school. I don't want to do that either. So that's only down all about October. Don, you got anything else for Mr. Joey Arena? I just call him Mr. Arena.
Mr. Arena, congratulations on everything. I'm super proud of you guys. My first time seeing you guys were... I was actually just watching the podcast. This was before Sebastian invited me on. And just to see your progress from then to now is impressive. Just keep doing what you're doing. Proud of you.
It's all you can do. You know, it's the love of the game, and it's just a constant grind, and that's it. It's all about consistency, honestly.
Exactly.
I want
progress. There you go.
Progress. I want to say thank you to Jade. I know she works with your team, and she's been kind of emailing me to get you on the show and whatnot. So thank you to her. Is there any shout outs or anything else you want to say before we end this episode, Joey?
Yeah. Shout out to my producer, JD, one of my best friends. Without him, a lot of this would not be happening. Shout out to one of my other producers, Evan McKeever. That's the beginning of it all. And, you know, big ups to obviously Octane. Thank you guys, honestly, so much. I have great time when we talk. I love open dialogue and just back and forth banter about anything and everything. And just again, all the fans that have supported us throughout the years and just continue to grow with us, that's huge. And Chris Motionless as well, who's just been an amazing friend, as well as just a person who always keeps looking out for the fans. So the people that help us, honestly, we couldn't do it without any of them.
That's awesome. All right. Well, Joey, thanks for coming on to the show. I do want to remind everyone to please subscribe to our YouTube channel. I forgot to say that in the very beginning because I have the new intro thing. I'm still working out the kinks on it, okay? Check us out on all podcasting platforms as well. Joey, please stay right there till after the outro song plays, if you will. And that's all the time we got. Peace out. Rock on.
Much love.
There we go.
This is the Loud Spot outro by Nothing Short of Tragic. Is this all talk with no action? No. Is this my thoughts with distraction? No. Is this what I bought that's in fashion? Or is this the Loud Spot with Sebastian? Yes. Does Nothing Short of Tragic have his back again? Yes. Does everything that's good really have to end? Pimp hoes have the pimp show, so to get more episodes, make an order, this is over.